Hi everybody, it's Dr. Magnifico from JR's Full Vet and Podly.com. This is Stella. We've done two other videos this morning about her. She is getting spayed today. She is a chocolate lab about 7 months old. She's had all of her puppy vaccines, all of her puppy visits. She had an exam before we did her spay. She had a pre-med given this morning and something for pain inflammation, and she is just waking up now. She's extubated and we're still monitoring her. I always want to monitor dogs post-op because, in my opinion, that's probably the most critical period for their recovery. Going home, so I want to go over some of the things to talk to your vet about going home. Going home, she's going to be given a medical pet shirt. So this is sort of a little onesie, and it's got little holes for her feet, and then a little snap place for her to go pee. So this will keep her from licking her incision. The other options are an e-collar, and there's always options to e-collar, so talk to your vet about which one's easier to live with, and then affordability. This one is about $15. It's really only good for about 24 hours, and then it sort of gets trashed by the dogs. And this is a better long-term option, but it's about $30. Medical pet shirt is about $25 here. She's gonna get monitored on her pulse ox, and we've just given her some sedation, so she will be calm and quiet waking up. Picking up this afternoon, she's gonna go home with pain medication. Those are gonna start tomorrow because she got a 24-hour dose today. Some instructions on keeping her quiet and calm, really for the next 14 days. She's got internal sutures and skin sutures and external sutures, and we wanna make sure that those stay intact with minimal stress on them. So really, the first couple of days are the most critical, so by tomorrow morning, I want her looking bright and active and happy. Her gum color, I want you to always check her gum color. So her gum color is nice and pink now. Tomorrow morning through the night, it should still look the same. And that's a really important indicator of internal bleeding along with her attitude. So as long as she's calm and comfortable, I'm happy for today. As long as by tomorrow morning, she's starting to be a little more interested in food, and you might want to talk to your vet about feeding. Typically, we'll just do small meals for about the first 24 hours. And certainly no meals until she is bright, alert, you know, looking like her normal self. You have to make sure that they can swallow normally. I also want the parents to come and look at the incision when they pick up. So here is her incision. It's nice and quiet and calm. There's really no swelling, no redness, and certainly no signs of infection. And signs of infection are heat, swelling, redness, any kind of discharge, especially if the discharge is yellow or green. If she's licking at it, that's a sign that it's bothering her. You know, it's not just keeping her from licking at it, it's that if she wants to lick at it, you have to pay attention that she's not telling you there's a problem. So really listen and pay attention to your dog. Don't hesitate to ask your vet lots of questions. Make sure they're accessible to you. Through this clinic, you can get us on Facebook messaging. I give my email to everybody so they can email me. And certainly if you have any concerns in the middle of the night, go to the emergency clinic. It's always better to be safe and sorry. Lots of tips and tricks that you can find at Jarrettsville Vet on my blog, Diary of a Real Life Veterinarian, and you can always ask a question at Podly.com. I expect that she'll be sleeping for another hour or two. She just came off of the surgery table, so really she should be calm and quiet for another hour or two. And then as the day goes on, she should be opening her eyes, wagging her tail, responding to her name, and sort of interacting a little bit more. She will be leash walked and cage rested for the next couple of days just to make sure she's not in the house running or jumping on the couch or any of that kind of stuff. If you have any questions, you can find me at Jarrettsville Vet or Podly.com. Take care.